In this video, we're going to learn about the alignment tools, and they're actually found on the top toolbar, only we don't see them until we've got more than one object selected. Let me demonstrate by first selecting on a new design tab with an empty workspace, and perhaps what I could do is simply draw a rectangle or two or three. And so here we've got one, two, three different shapes, and I'm going to use my rectangle selection tool to select all three of them. And notice that as soon as I have more than one shape selected, that the top toolbar has expanded and it now includes options for align and shaping. So in this video, we will focus in on the align option, and with align, if I click on the tool and hold, it shows me that I have options for aligning everything to the left, everything to the center, to the right, to the top, to the center, to the bottom, and then we can also choose equal spacing, both vertical and horizontal. So let's try top and see how it aligns all three shapes along their top. Let's hit undo and then use align and say left. It makes them all overlap each other to the left. Undo. Align, center. It aligns them all along their center horizontal lines. Undo. Align, right. The opposite of left is right. Undo. Align centers. Now it's going to keep them, not squish them together, but keep them with their horizontal spacing intact, but align them along their horizontal centers. And undo, and then finally align bottom. So again, keeping the horizontal spacing intact, but aligning along the bottom. Now let's make a point of, in fact, why don't we even have one more object here? I'll duplicate it. And so these ones are very close together. These ones have a little more space between them. What if you wanted them all to have a balanced space between? So let me move this over. First of all, let's say align. And then tops. So they're all aligned along the same top row. And now we can say align, and we can do equal spacing along the horizontal line. And so it just balances the amount of space between each of the shapes. And so this is a way, and the opposite could be done if I hit undo with align, is equal vertical spacing. And so it makes sure that, and maybe that's not a good example. So if you had one that was up here and one that was down here and you selected them all, so I'll go Control A to select all and then do align equal spacing vertically, and it figures out the equal amount of space between each one. And so if we did align vertically and then we did align horizontally, we would have kind of a balanced amount of space between each of the different shapes, even though the shapes are different. And so that is how to use the align tool. And once again, you need to have at least two objects selected before you will see the alignment tool.